Hello and welcome to Auspol Explained. I'm your long curly haired host David, and today let's talk about how the election is called if the counting continues. Recently, Australia had an election, you may have noticed. On election night, polls close at 6 p.m. local time and the AEC is counting all those votes and providing live updates of the count as it comes in, but the AEC themselves won't declare winners for about a week and a half. They do that after votes have been double-checked and counted to a point of absolute mathematical certainty of the outcome. And yet, the news declared a bunch of winners and said who will form government on election night. How? Well, the news is using statistical trends and models to create predictions. During the night, those predictions can fluctuate and the number of projected seats won by a party may go up or down, especially in the earlier hours as more information comes in. But eventually it does become clear that there is enough data to make some more solid predictions, even if they're not 100% certainties. Let's imagine a seat where there are four candidates, John, Paul, George, and Ringo, and there's 100,000 voters overall. After counting, you know, a few hundred or thousand votes, you can get a picture of how it's shaping up and who might be near the top or bottom, but you can't make any predictions, there's not enough data. The support for a candidate might be stronger in some parts of an electorate than other, so you'll have shifts and adjustment over time, but eventually you're going to start getting some statistical averages. So let's say at 30% of the count, we see 45% support for John, 30% for Paul, 15% for George, and 10% for Ringo. Bow, bow. It's looking good for John, and we can likely consider this a two-candidate race between John and Paul. I mean, yeah, there's still 70,000 votes left uncounted, and sure, hypothetically, 90% of those could go to Ringo, and he wins in a landslide, but like, that's absurdly statistically unlikely, it's just not gonna happen. If the trend continues, our winner in this case will likely be John, unless there's all of a sudden overwhelming support from preference flows from Ringo and George to Paul, that could put him on top, but maybe historically Ringo and George supporters are more likely to preference John, and we can adequately predict that we're not going to have a 100% flip on that. So after a while, it becomes pretty clear where the results are heading, and it's only a matter of time not to determine who wins, but by how much. Some seats are much easier to predict than others. Like if a candidate is trending above 50% of the first preferences, then it's pretty safe to assume they'll win outright. Most seats, however, do require preference counts, which comes after tallying all the first preferences. Often there can be two candidates with large leads over the others in terms of first preferences, so already it's easier to narrow it down into who the potential winners are. The closer or more complex the count, like say three candidates are all getting about 30-something percent in first preferences, well then the longer then it'll take to make any kind of prediction by news analysts. There are lots of other complicating factors like pre-poll and postal votes that sometimes may statistically lean slightly more one way than the other, and that might make predicting a few seats difficult for a while. But often on election night itself, there'll be enough information to predict that Labor or the Coalition are doing better than each other and what the outcome is likely to be. Like, as of recording, still have no idea how many seats Labor or the Coalition will have at the end of this election. We don't know how big the crossbench will be, but we do have enough data to show that Labor is far ahead in enough seats that it'd be an absurd statistical unlikelihood for the votes to suddenly just favour the Coalition well above the average of what's already been counted and overturn those margins. There may be some seats that look currently like they'll be won by Labor or the Coalition, but actually narrowly turn around and be won by someone else. That is possible. This is also why you may look at the vote count for some seats that may look like, oh hey, this person's winning by like 1 or 2%, but the ABC still hasn't called it. There could be some complicating factors, and they're not confident that they have enough data. But like I said, some seats are close and more difficult to predict. The smaller the margin or the more complicated the preference counts, the longer it'll take for us to know. We don't always know the winner on election night, like there have been some very close elections. 2016, for example, still had no idea who was going to be the government after a week of counting. The Coalition did eventually win by a single seat at like about 8 days in, I think it was. Now the thing is, The government is formed in the House of Representatives, which is way quicker to count than the Senate, because that's super complex. So while the Senate count takes weeks, it doesn't actually change who is in government, only changes who the government needs to negotiate when it comes to passing legislation. So election analysts have called it for Labour, but that's not the same as being officially declared. That comes later by the AEC once counting is finalised. So as of right now, we won't know the final makeup of the House of Representatives or the Senate. We won't know for a while, but based off some mathematical trends and statistics, we can very confidently say before counting has finished that Labour has won a majority of seats in the 2025 election. So that's how it works. The answer? Maths. It's all statistics, folks. It's all maths. That's basically it. It's statistical models, it's trends, and it's just figuring out where things are going. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed learning more about this election or elections in general. I produced a fair few explainers and I'm glad to have so many new people subscribed. So hello, welcome. I will be making more explainers now about how Parliament works to help you understand a few more things before we get to the next election in the future. If you'd like to, feel free to share, subscribe, comment down below. If your seat has been declared yet, or if it's still uncertain, according to the ABC. And of course, also thank you so much to my supporters on Patreon, who give me a little bit of money and will gain access to a bunch of episodes early. That's all from me. I'll see you next time.